Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Enderal. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading The Path, Tome 4, The Departure, which I found right here in Greybeard's Potion Parlor in the Ark Foreign Quarter. Tome 4, The Departure. Verse 25. Secluded and perilous, an untamed land, that is how Enderal was before the revelation of the Lightborn. Wild creatures roam freely, and rich forests reach from east to west and from south up to north's wintry mountains. Verse 26. And it came to pass that Malphus descended and appeared to a woman and a man. The woman's name was Selna, the man's was Keteran. Both were lowborn and had to endure great anguish during the wars of their country. They lived in a decrepit hut amidst a city that was scarred by devastation. However, they were pious and of good will. Replete with awe, they fell to their knees as the Lightborn appeared before them, since both were witnesses of the revelation of the Lightborn and acknowledged him as one of the seven true gods. Verse 27. And Malphus spoke, "Arise, my children, and rejoice, for you are about to be accorded a great honor. From this day forward you shall serve me solely. Your punishment will be severe should you fail me. However, if you serve me sincerely, you shall experience eternity in my name." Verse 28. It was Selna who answered first. "O Lord, we submit, for we recognize your divinity, yet how can you bestow eternity upon us? We are humans, and not even the blood of a Asataran's son, the Eterna, courses through our veins. In 20 years I will wither. In 40 years only bones will remain. That is the way of the world, and not even a Asataran was able to change that." Malphus approached the woman. His voice was hard as stone, but still full of wisdom and empathy. "That is how it was under his subjugation. That is how it was in the profane years which you have lived through. But we, O children, we are true gods. See and bear witness to my endless power." Verse 29. And the figure of light, which was Malphus, turned around and raised his hands heavenward, and thousands of lightning bolts shot downwards. They shattered Selna's and Keteran's miserable hut with a loud crack and destroyed the wretched city surrounding them. Yes, even those who harbored doubt despite the Lightborn's revelation and whose souls were tainted were smashed. The odor of smoke and ashes filled the air. Verse 30. No harm befell Selna and Keteran, nor the 200 men and women who had gathered around the Lightborn, who were full of anguish and veneration. Malphus lowered his arms and spoke with his head held high. Verse 31. "We are gods and rulers over the elements, time, and life itself, and as surely as I am standing here, I proclaim, those who follow me and honor my teachings wander upon my path. And should you tread properly to its end, I shall grant you entry to the eternal paths, where you experience eternal bliss, peace, and exhilaration." Verse 32. Both Selna and Keteran, as well as the 200 destitute souls who were gathered around them, lowered their heads and understood, and so they became the first vassals. Verse 33. They all packed their belongings and followed Malphus to the coast, where two plain but solid ships awaited them. And Malphus spoke once again, "You shall be the offspring of my eternal kingdom. Board the ships and sail to the north until you spot the red star. It will guide you to the Holy Land, which unites winter, summer, and autumn. There you shall build the foundation for all the thousands who will follow you." And thus he vanished. This time became known as the month of departure. Verse 34. The first vassals pursued Malphus's call and set sail, unaware of their divine task. They do not know where their route would lead them, but they had faith. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Enderal. The Path, Tome 4, The Departure.